the Cardinal Sports Complex for CTN's live coverage of high school football. A night that many thought may never come has come at last. It's October the 9th, and we're finally kicking off the prep football season. Joe Young, Howie Shapiro, excited to be sidelined.
Yeah, it's hard to stay this far away from you. You know, we've been doing this for so long, but this is exciting because nobody thought this would happen, especially this time of year. So, I mean, Coon Rapids being able to open again against St. Thomas Academy, one of the perennial best teams in the state of Minnesota. This is going to be a great test for them, but it should be a lot of fun.
Obviously, it comes late. This season will have a lot of differences, a shorter season, no state tournament, but at least they get to compete. A six-game schedule starts tonight against St. Thomas Academy, who has been the state runner-up the last 2 years in a row. Last year started at St. Thomas Academy, the Cadets blanking the Cardinals 34-0. The Cadets had four shutouts in their eight-game regular season.
Yeah, they also lost 17 starters from a year ago, but you know what? They're a factory. They reload. And talking to Coach Russin today, Joe, he said this is a great test for us because, you know, we had a great test last year. One of the coaches said, you know, I feel better about this season than I did about the season ago. So there's a lot of optimism in this Coon Rapids camp right now.
Well, and when you talk about the shortened preseason and didn't know if the season was going to happen or not, the place that's most affected is the quarterback, and the Cadets have a new man under center and just a short time to prepare to take on a good Coon Rapids team.
Well, Baker Redding's a very good quarterback. He actually got a fair amount of time last year as well, but he is going to lead this Cadet team, and you know they're going to want to run the ball. They're a running team, but they also rely on Baker Redding to lead that offense. He's going to run the ball as well, but he's going to try and open it up and mix it up with some passes as well.
Well, and for Coon Rapids last year, their first state tournament appearance ending in the semifinals against eventual champion Chaska. And a big part of that was the elusiveness of David Giebley, and he's one of the pieces they bring back.
David's a phenomenal player. And the first thing head coach Dan O'Brien of St. Thomas Academy said to me, we have to watch out for David Giebley because he's so explosive. Not only is he going to run the ball from the backfield, but he's a starting linebacker on this defense. So he's going to be all over the field on both sides of the ball. The Cadets need to make sure that they keep him in check.
Well, and the fans are very limited, only 250 spectators, so it will have a different atmosphere than most, but they're kicking off the 2020 season. The kids are excited, we're excited, and we'll have kickoff between the Cadets and the Cardinals next on CTN. Inside Access, your ticket behind the scenes of Coon Rapids sports.
Studio and Howie, it feels great to be back behind the desk.
I can't think of too many things better in life. How about you?
I can think of one. Because it's an all-out sprint to the finish.
Okay. Kind of like your life.
They host Elk River on Tuesday, and Howie?
We'll be there.
There you go. It's contagious.
I like that it's all your fault.
Yeah, of course it is.
Sportside, I'm Joe Young.
I'm Joe Young as well.
And I'm not so sure how good we'll look on HD, but you know.
I appreciate the effort.
I try.
I do. Back at the Cardinals Sports Complex, ready to kick it off. The Cardinals will get the first possession of the game.
David Giebley. Well,
Joe, you know, this Cardinal team, you know, even though they lost some pretty good players from a year ago, they've got some really nice skill position players coming back, and we're going to see it here tonight. And they're big across the front, you know. It's going to be an exciting season.
Rogalski with a kick deep to the near side. It'll bounce, be taken by Doe at the 10, looking for a seam in the middle, cutting back across the right, spins, but is dropped just shy of the 20-yard line. So not a bad starting field position for the Cardinals from their own 19.
Well, you know, and again, it'll be an interesting situation because they've got some different things that they're doing, and they're replacing a quarterback in Jake Van Hulsen. It's got some large shoes to fill. And Griffin Tom, a sophomore, is going to get the opportunity to start out here and try and fill those shoes.
He is in the pistol with Giebley in the backfield with him. Low snap. He's able to scoop it up. Broken play, looking for room on the left. We'll get back to the line of scrimmage, but nothing more. Second and 10.
Yeah, it's unfortunately started with a bad snap. And Griffin Tom had nothing to do but try and gain some positive yardage.
Three receivers to the right on second and 10 for the Cardinals. Giebley will stay in the backfield. Better snap. Tom looks to the right, throws on the little bubble screen. It's Jordan Doe complete, and he's going to be stopped for a loss at the 15-yard line. It's going to be third and 14 from deep in their own end.
You and I were chatting before the game about how good that St. Thomas Academy defense was last year. And right now they look to try and smother what Coon Rapids wants to do on offense. You see the starters go by there for the Cadets.
Team that has made it to the state championship game 2 years in a row. They had two losses all season last year. The regular season finale, 20-0 at the hands of Chaska. And then again in the state championship game. And Tom's pass incomplete, looking for Sonny Tao down the right sideline. A quick three and out for Coon Rapids.
Yeah, not the way that the Cardinals wanted to start their first offensive drive here. But they will have to kick, and should be pretty good field position for St. Thomas.
Anthony Bickford and Grady O'Neill are the deep back, standing at the Coon Rapids 45, awaiting the punt from Jordan Doe, who stands at his own goal line. Low line drive punt. Takes Bickford back, he fields it, and then slips and falls at his own 44. Still great field position for St. Thomas Academy to start.
Yeah, I want to give a big shout out to the great TV audience we're going to have tonight. Everybody around, of course, the Coon Rapids area watching, hopefully, and hopefully we'll enjoy the broadcast. And I know we've got a lot of St. Thomas Academy alumni and fans out watching as well, so welcome to the broadcast. But big shout out to everybody in CTN and Cardinal Country, Cardinal Nation.
On first down, play action rolling out, and throwing is Redding. He's got a couple of receivers in the area, not really close to either of them. Angelo Pasiga got tripped up as he and the Cardinal defensive back got tangled. So now second and 10 from their own 45-yard line. I formation in the backfield behind Redding. He's under center. Handoff goes to McFadden. Hole closes quickly. It'll be third and 10.
Yeah, great job by the defense that time. Just collapsing in the middle, not allowing any room for McFadden to get through.
Brought down to the play by number three.
Looked like there was a hole to the right, but it immediately got stopped up, and now third and long for St. Thomas Academy.
We'll see what the defense does here. If they're going to bring somebody at this point, put a little pressure on the quarterback.
Redding under center, man in motion is O'Neill. Handoff is going to go to McFadden off the left side into Coon Rapids territory. He's going to be stopped short of a first down, but it's going to be relatively close, fourth and about a yard and a half.
Yeah, and they'll definitely go for it in this situation. Again, Cardinal defense, I think, thought pass. They did a nice job of blocking the interior part of that line and opened up a hole for him in order to gain some positive yards as he almost reached that first down marker.
This would be a big stop right here for the Coon Rapids defense. Shifting from right to left is Kotak. High formation in the backfield behind Redding. Handoff goes to McFadden. He's going to have the first down across the 45.
and close to the 43.
Well, that offensive front got enough of a push to push that defensive front back in order to pick up the first down. We talked about David Gibley before, in on the tackle. Strong player from both sides of the ball.
Two receivers to the left on first down for Baker Redding. Straight drop, looks that way, chased. He'll roll, still looking and throws. That pass complete to O'Neal down the sideline. He's knocked out close to the 10-yard line.
O'Neal did a really nice job of slipping behind the defense, and Redding, to his credit, did a nice job of rolling to his left, and then just a soft little toss. As you're going to see here, good protection for him, just that run-pass option, and he's able to just throw it over the top of the defense, and a reception for the Cadets, tackled by Antonio Manos.
32-yard gain, first and 10 from the 11 on the opening drive of the season for the St. Thomas Academy Cadets. Strong side right, eye formation, two receivers to the left, handoff goes off the left side, spinning, and the ball came out. This was,
I think Cardinals have it.
Adebayo on his first carry of the year, and Coon Rapids able to strip it, but the Cadets able to come up with it.
Yeah, Cardinals thought they had it, and fortunately for St. Thomas, that was lineman, offensive lineman, Javon Lungalo, that fell on the football. Oh, I'm sorry, wrong roster.
That'll happen.
I'll get
the. Welcome
get this
to the
eventually.
First game of the year. Oh boy, a couple of Cardinals had it, and it just
Leo
squirted
Bloom.
Free.
Leo Bloom.
Turns out to be a 5-yard gain, second and 5 from the 6. Pitch goes to McFadden, running left. He's got blockers ahead of him. He'll be stopped very close to the first down. Looks like they're going to mark him closer to the 3-yard line, so it'll be 3rd and about 2.
Again, that defense is just trying to pursue laterally, and McFadden trying just to gain that edge.
Oh, even as back as far as the 4, yeah. So only a gain of a, yeah. A gain of 2 makes it 3rd and 3 from the 4.
Brings up 3rd and 4 for the Cadets. Cut him down.
Tight ends on both sides for the Cadets on 3rd and 3 from the 4. Handoff goes to McFadden. Nice hole left side. Flag in the backfield. Yeah, he's into the end zone. But this one's going to come back.
Yeah, again. We're going to see what they call, but I think one of the linemen got a hold. Yeah, right there.
The tackle over there. That's a big penalty. Backs him back to the 14, so it'll be 3rd and 13 from the 14. They can get a first down at the 1-yard line.
Now it puts a little bit more pressure now if you're further out from the goal line. And a big opportunity for the defense here. Obviously, it'll be 4 down territory, I believe. Well, we'll see if they decide to kick a field goal, but nonetheless, good opportunity for the defense to make a play here.
Pasiga and O'Neal lined up wide right. Out of the pistol is Redding. Little swing pass. McFadden's got some room on the right side. He's got a blocker and speed. He's into the end zone, and the Cadets are on the board.
Now McFadden did a really nice job of turning the corner. And once he turned the corner, he just lowered his head a little bit. And he's not a big running back, but as you mentioned, he is fast, he is quick and elusive. And he was able to gain the edge and get the first score of the day here for the Cadets. And I think Antonio Manos was hurt on the play as he's walking of an injury with an issue with his shoulder, maybe. It looks like he took a hit at the end of that.
Could be a heavy blow for the Cardinals, one of the defensive starters they bring back from last year's state tournament team.
Tristan Trudeau taking his place on the defensive end.
Seth Moore, the left-footed kicker, puts it up and through. And it is a 7-0 lead for St. Thomas Academy. So Coon Rapids defense looked like they might be able to hold for a three and out, but a fourth down conversion for St. Thomas Academy, one big play and then another on the recovery after the penalty down on the goal line. Took points off the board. McFadden gets in on his second chance.
Yeah, again, that penalty didn't deter what the Cadets wanted to do on offense.
Well, Coon Rapids, just a quick three and out. Had the ball less than 90 seconds. Now they need to be able to respond with some possession and yardage.
Well, we'll see how the Cardinal offense can respond here after going three and out, and then defense letting the Cadets get into the end zone to start their first drive.
Number 32, Mark Rogalski in to kick for the Cadets. Number 3, David Cheevely, and number 4, Jordan Doe. Back deep for the Cardinals.
Mark Rogalski to kick it away. St. Thomas now the 7-0 lead. He's going to squib it up the middle. Bouncing around, the Cardinals just have to fall on it at the 21.
Oh, so
Unfortunately, Jordan Doe able to hop on top of it.
They'll start relatively with the same field position they had to start their first drive.
Oh, sorry, it was David Giebley that got on top of it. So right at the 20 is where they mark it. Roughly the exact same spot. Cardinals went backwards on their opening drive. Now needing to be able to respond. Tom out of the shotgun, hands off to Giebley, trying to find some room, fighting for extra yardage. And boy, he does not go down easily, does he?
No,
gain of close to 4.
He's a strong, strong young man. And again, we talked about it in the opening. Coach Dan O'Brien of the Cadets said, we have to make sure we bring him to the ground. We can't miss tackles on that young man. He's powerful. He's got lower body strength. And we just got to make sure that we tackle him to the ground.
Two receivers either side for Tom. They sprint Giebley out as well. Quarterback draw. He's going to pick up about 3 more. I'm not sure if that was designed or broken, but it'll be a short run for Griffin Tom. And it'll bring up another third down, 3rd and 4.
Now a big third down here for the offense. They would like to continue this drive rather than turn it right back to over to their defense. You know, I'm sure as a sophomore, Griffin Tom, I'm sure
a lot of men in the box in white. A high snap up over the head of Tom, scooped up by Giebley, and he's going to be buried and dragged back into the end zone. We'll see where they mark it. They mark his forward progression at the 10, so a loss of 16.
That's the second bad snap we've seen in two drives, in as many drives, and that's an unfortunate situation for the Cardinals. Because as you mentioned, that pushes them way back, and now they're punting from their end zone. Yeah, nowhere for Giebley to go at that point. Good job. Good job.
So
on
4th
the play.
And 20, and we're going to see Jordan Doe punting out of his own end zone.
It was Garrison Soliday on the tackle for the Cadets.
Nearly blocked, almost straight up, and not going much anywhere. Fortunately, taking a Coon Rapids bounce, but phenomenal field position as it's downed at the 23. That's where the cadets will take over.
Yeah, and you do not want to give St. Thomas Academy a short field, especially in this situation, as short as it is. They're a good offense, and that just puts, again, immediate pressure back on your defense.
Always nice to start in plus territory. This one almost in the red zone. Two receivers right. Pitch goes to the left. And not a lot of running room this time for McFadden as he's brought down after a short gain.
Yeah, good pursuit by the defense.
Danny McFadden brought down the play. Number 54, Ethan Olada.
Gain of about a yard.
And that was just a really fine tackle by Ethan Owada as he just he met McFadden there and brought him down.
Tight end on the right side. I had formation behind Redding on second and nine. McFadden blows through a big hole in across the 15. It'll set up third and short.
Well, Joe, we always talk about who wins the battle at the point of attack. And right now, or it's early, but right now St. Thomas doing a really job of good job of controlling both lines of scrimmage.
It'll be third and one from the 14. Redding back under center on third and short. Handoff goes to McFadden. He's got the first down and more inside the 10 and finally taken down close to the 7. It'll be first and goal.
Yeah, just methodically. I mean, we talked about it at the beginning of the show. They're going to want to run the ball, and they like to run the ball. That's really their style, and they do a really nice job. They've got some good guys up front to open up those holes. And McFadden, as we talked about, not the biggest of backs, but he's shifty.
Well, and with how much size they have on that front line, pretty easy to get lost in amongst the trees.
Yeah.
He's dotting the I behind Redding on first and goal from the 7. He'll get the carry again, and he'll get to the end zone again. McFadden's second score of the game makes it 13-0, St. Thomas Academy.
Yeah, look at the job the offensive line does. It's a huge hole up front, and McFadden, really not much contact as he gets to the end zone.
Seth Moore out to attempt the extra point. It is up. It is good. It is 14-0, St. Thomas Academy.
You know, the Town Square Television, who's located out in the area of where St. Thomas Academy is, we're going to again see that run by McFadden. They're taking our feed, so we welcome that audience as well. Big shout out to my buddy Mike Shuno out there watching. Told me that the game is on TV.
We worked with them for St. Thomas Academy.
Yep.
Beautiful press box, by the way, at St. Thomas Academy. Man. If we could, I know they're putting some facilities, some money into facilities around the Anoka-Hennepin District.
Yep.
You know, if we could have a press box like St. Thomas Academy's, probably not in the budget.
Until we called the game at the bank, that was the nicest press box that I've been in.
I would. That's fair.
Yeah. Until we come. But
XL Energy.
Yeah. That was nice as well. But it's just. I just loved. I love. First of all, I love the fact that it was air conditioned. So for a big guy like me, that's enjoyable.
Rogalski ready to kick it away again. Pretty deep kick first time. Second time, a squibber. The third one. More of a line drive will skip and roll. and be scooped up at the 1 yard line by Jordan Doe. Makes one man miss, trying to cut back to the middle, and Coon Rapids is going to be pinned deep in their own end once again.
Makes it very difficult for your offense when you give this kind of a long field, and you know, just it, especially now you're trailing 14 to nothing, so a little more pressure on you to try and produce offensively, and you've got a long field to do so.
Number nine, Ryan Creamer on the tackle for the Cadets.
Well, it's definitely a credit to Rogalski making it difficult to get hold of his kicks. And the coverage has been there, so Coon Rapids stuck deep in their own end. Rolling and throwing is Tom. The pass is complete to Sonny Tao, trying to break a tackle. Dives forward to the 17, a gain of 7.
Well, that's,
sorry,
that's
that was Jordan Doe.
And that, see, now that's what they need. They need some productive plays in this situation. They need to pick up chunks of yardage like the 7 that they just did. And they want to try and put a little pressure on the Cadet defense. Right now the Cadet defense is... had, in the first two series, have had their way with them.
Two receivers on the left, one to the right. Handoff goes to Jeebly. He's met immediately, but able to push his way forward to about the 18-yard line. It'll be third down.
It's a big third down situation for the offense. They certainly do not want to go three and outs.
All within the first quarter. A little more than a minute remaining here in quarter number one. Out of the pistol is Tom. Hard count, trying to get the Cadets to jump. They back off, reset their defense, still showing pressure. Another high snap, this one into the end zone, and this is going to be a safety.
Wow. I would say they have some issues that they need to work out from the center position. I mean, that's three on three drives. Two over the head and one in the ground. Yeah, man, that's not even close.
Long snap is a lost art.
It's not easy to do. It's not easy to do.
And no, not only does it put points on the board for St. Thomas, but means they'll get the ball right back.
Right.
And again, with pretty good field position, the free kick will come from the 20-yard line.
Yeah, I mean, and certainly not much Tom can do about that. That's well over his head. And Coach Russin certainly cannot be happy with the way the sequence of events here have started out for the Cardinal football squad.
And it's unfortunate because it makes it, the hole being as big as it is, still only two scores.
True.
But you have yet to get a first down.
Right. And that's the
so,
thing.
So, but the hardest part of it may be to get the guys to not come unraveled and lose focus, because the game is far from over. But it's not always that easy to explain that to 16, 17, and 18-year-olds.
You know, this is true, you know, and they knew coming in they're playing a team that's a quality team, obviously, and not that the Cardinals are not. It's just the fact that it's been a change in sequences, and they need to be able to get a little confidence, I think, on the offensive end, and in order to keep drives alive. And it started with a nice little 7-yard pass, but then they just couldn't convert after that.
Ali Abdelrahim will kick it for the Cardinals for the first time this year. Kicking it from his own 20-yard line. Bickford and O'Neill are the deep backs. They stand at their own 26-yard line.
Number 22, Ali Abdelrahim, and he kicks for the Cardinals.
Abdelrahim, good high end-over-end kick. Bickford waits for it at the 30 and heads back to his left, trying to get around the corner, and does, into Coon Rapids territory, down to the 46-yard line. So two out of three possessions for St. Thomas Academy, starting on Coon Rapids' side of the field. The one time that it wasn't, it was at their own 45.
Yeah, I mean, again, great field position for an offense that's so far doing what they want to do.
There's a solid return from Bickford, a return of 24 yards. They're even going to give it to 45. So first and 10 from the Coon Rapids 45, 38 seconds remaining here in the first quarter. Inside counter to McFadden gets him 5 yards down to the 40.
He does a nice job of just cutting and turning up field in that situation. And he did get a hand on him to be brought down, but not before he gained the 5 yards. You can see Giebley on there is going to bring him down.
Reach him for the ball.
Yeah.
And a good hold on the leather by Danny McFadden. And they're just going to let the time expire. That'll do it for the first quarter. It's been all St. Thomas Academy. They lead Coon Rapids 16-0 as we head to the second quarter.
After quarantine, everyone's bound to look a little different. Some people gained a little weight, others lost some. Some had longer hair or a new beard. With Joe and Howie, it was a little different. Don't get me wrong, they acted like the same old Joe and Howie. But they came back with a different energy. But something was off.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Sports Night. I'm Joe Young.
And I'm Howie Shapiro. And
back at the Cardinals Stadium, Coon Rapids trailing St. Thomas Academy by a 16-0 score. Three times, three and out, the last ending in a safety. And St. Thomas Academy on the roll again, second and five from the Coon Rapids 40-yard line.
Well, the last thing what this defense cannot afford is to give up any more points at this point. I mean, they cannot afford to get that far behind.
Pitch is going to go wide on the right side to Abadeo, and he's got a lot of room. Spins his way down close to the 10-yard line. Flag on the play.
We'll see what they call. I couldn't really see in that area what they were going to call. I don't know if they call a hold in that area, but it looks like it might be coming back. I think
the question is, where was it? I think it's still going to be a first down based on where the flag is on the field.
Yeah, because it was after the play.
It's a personal foul. Coon Rapids.
Yeah, that's not good. I don't know where exactly they called it.
Or what exactly happened, but that'll be tagged on to the end of the run. So I would assume it's going to be half the distance,
yeah,
first and goal from the five.
Yeah.
Looks like that's where they've got the ball marked.
It indeed is at the five.
So a gain of 30 on the play by Adebayo. Great blocking out in front of a good design. They ran that inside counter look. And Coon Rapids definitely bit. Not a bio had a big lane to run around the outside on the right. Had some blockers down there. He's the lone setback here on first and goal. The handoff goes to McFadden. Cutting back up, reaching, and into the end zone. His third score just 34 seconds into the second quarter.
Well, the positive thing is Tony Omano's back into the ball game after suffering a little bit of an injury on that last touchdown. But the unfortunate thing for Coon Rapids, now you've given up another score to a very good squad, and you've yet to get your offense going in this one. Nice job by McFadden just to be able to reach over, top the pylon, and get the score.
Seth Moore, low line drive this time, but same result. It's good, and it's 23-0, St. Thomas Academy. That drive, just three plays.
Well, and again, the McFadden doing a nice job of getting around the corner, but it was all really Love Abadeo, who, with a nice run, then, of course, the personal foul tacked on to get it down to the five.
Kind of interested to see what Mark Rogalski has for us on kick number four. He's kicked three times.
Yeah,
not one of
different.
Them has been the same. And all have had great results for his coverage team. Two stops right at the 21, all the way down to the 10. And really on that last one, Jordan Dole was forced to pick that up because I don't know that it would have gotten into the end zone.
Yeah, I agree with you there. I thought at first maybe it was going to go out the sideline, but then it stayed in bounds, and he had to have picked it up because it may have died at the one. And you got to make sure you fall on it.
Well, and he was at least able to fight his way back to the 10, yep. But we all know what happened after that.
We do.
Gibley and Doe are the deep backs for Coon Rapids. Another squib kick up the middle, taken on a hop at the 25. Returned in the middle across the 30 to the 32-yard line.
Oh, good field position here now to start the fourth drive on offense for Coon Rapids.
It was Emmanuel Gordon on the return. Not a great spot for the Cardinals, put right at the 30. And you just start by getting a first down at this point.
And that's what I said the last drive. It started with a 7-yard completion. And again, that's a positive thing for this offense. But as you mentioned, we saw what happened after that.
Griffin Tom rolling right, throwing. Pass is nearly picked off. Doe fighting for it, able to win it back. But that one was almost right to Ryan Creamer.
He threw it just a tad behind him.
And Doe was able to wrestle it away from him.
Oh, you see it just. Actually, it wasn't a bad throw. It's just the fact that he was right, the defender was right there, and you are correct. They are fighting for possession of that football.
Second and six from the 34. Play action in trouble, and the sack. That's Oscar Berg wrapping up and taking Tom to the turf.
Yeah, again, nice job by Berg as he beat his blocker. You're going to see 66 just beat his man and right to Tom, and it puts the Cardinals now in third and long in a situation where they're desperate for a first down.
Well, positive yardage, even.
Yeah.
Quick pass to Gibley, shakes off a tackle, breaks another, has a first down and more. Out across midfield, cuts back, has help, and has speed. Can they catch him as he crosses the 20, the 10, down the sideline and into the end zone? Touchdown, Coon Rapids!
Oh, David Gibley is such a fine runner, and again, he's got such good field vision as he's able to make that cut up the field. He is such a good athlete, and that's the one thing Coach O'Brien said. We have to be careful. We have to bring him to the ground. We have to tackle him, but he is so explosive.
Shakes off that first hit right there, a good stiff arm, and then it's all done with the legs. And as you mentioned, the vision, making guys miss, coming back across, getting help from his teammates, and then just the pure speed to run to that far corner and not give up a 70-yard touchdown. Has Coon Rapids on the board, they'll line up and go for two.
You think that gives them a little momentum, Joe? And again,
it certainly helps.
Yeah, it does. Well, they needed it because their offense just hadn't been performing up until then. And
play action, Tom rolls, now throws, complete. Doe is in Two-point conversion is good.
Yeah, again, and that's a shot in the arm for the Cardinals because they were down. I guarantee you, they were down 23-0, and they said, we need to make something happen. We need a spark on our side line, and David Gibley gave it to him.
And now the chance just to be able to kick it off and hopefully give St. Thomas a longer field.
Exactly.
St. Thomas has three scoring drives, but their longest drive was 55 yards.
Yep. And again, I wasn't sure if Zach Santorizos was going to catch him or not, but just a great job of getting to the end zone. And here's the two-point conversion. Nice job, Tom, to Nolan.
Jordan Nolan hasn't been here in a while.
I don't mean Nolan.
Jordan Doe.
Jordan Doe.
Yeah, the first name.
I had the first name right. I just should have said Jordan.
But yeah, a huge shot in the arm as the Cardinals had negative yardage through their first three offensive possessions and a 70-yard strike after it looked like they had stumbled again after giving up the snap.
Well, and Doe's one of the playmakers on this team that they're relying on, and we saw him do well last year. And you know, just again, does a nice job of using his speed to get to the edge, and that'll be the last time I call him Nolan.
Mark that down.
Yeah, mark it down in the truck.
Abdel Rahim to kick it away. High, short kick. O'Neal will take it from the 16. Look for room on the right side. Blows through. Wrapped up, but spins away. And now he's going to have a huge return. He's back across midfield and into Cardinal territory, down to the 40-yard line. So much for shortening their field.
You know, when your special team's able to come through for you like that, that's a nice return. As again, he should have been tackled, and he spun out of one. Sonny Tao, it looked like he had him, and he spun away from him, and he does a nice job of cutting to the opposite side of the field and picking up a really nice, some nice yardage for the Cadets.
Yeah, you'll take a 44-yard kick return just about every time.
Absolutely.
Baker Redding. And a timeout before first down.
There you see the time remaining. 9:22 in the half, and the Cardinals trailing 23-8. Well, now you talk to your defense, and you see, you know, this is the offense came through, got a score. This is the time to come up with a stop.
They could definitely use it, but, you know, again, they have a short field behind them, and the Cadets right away into four down territory.
Yeah, no, there's no question about that.
Making that job that much more difficult.
Look at those two handsome guys. So the Cadets' average field position is the Coon Rapids 41. That's pretty good.
Well, fourth drive, three of the four, again, on Coon Rapids' side of midfield. And the one drive they had to start in their own end, they had to start all the way back at their own 45, which is, you know, tough to think of. Out of the pistol, rolling out. Redding wants to go long. This one hung up there, and the pass is incomplete, intended for Pasiga down that right sideline.
Yeah, Pasiga tried to get behind the defense. And that pass hung up a little bit. He actually had it in his hand as well.
Well, that one hung up on Redding a little bit.
Edward Tabla on the coverage for the Cardinals.
Baker Redding will go back under center. McFadden the single setback. O'Neal the wideout on the left will go in motion. They'll pitch it to him. Running right, cutting back, hit hard, and dropped after a gain of about four.
For the Cardinals.
Put the ball right on the 7-yard line, so third and 7.
Well, this is where you have to be concerned about McFadden and gaining that edge. If you're the defense, you just got to make sure you push it to the sideline, because when he gets that edge, he's pretty quick.
High formation, two receivers to the right. Tight end is on the left side. Cardinals jumped. And you know, we talk a lot about, obviously you never want penalties, but certain times when they seem almost more costly than the yardage, because now instead of third and 7, it's third and 2.
Yeah, and you, I mean, you don't want to give this offense anything. You don't want to give anything away in this situation.
Rolling right, the option pitch goes to McFadden. He gets the corner, and he's got another big gain and another trip to the end zone. He's been there 4 times, and we're not even halfway through the second quarter.
Yeah, and again, he's got that speed. Once he gains the edge, you're going to have a difficult time catching him as he's able to turn it upfield for the score. But, yeah, I mean, again, watch, he'll get the corner, and then he's just going to take a little cut to the inside as the defender falls, and it's an easy path for McFadden to find his 4th touchdown of the game.
Oh, did we miss a flag?
Oh, I didn't see a flag. They never said anything. I guess we did. So take that off the board.
So it must have happened after the first down, because it's 1st and 10 from the 24. Handoff goes to the up back and out of Bayou. Gains about 5.
Tristan Trudeau on the tackle for Coon Rapids. I mean, they've got a couple of nice young running backs on this team. Of course, McFadden, the senior, but Adebayo is just a sophomore.
Second and 6 from the 21. Kotak shifts to the left side. Handoff goes to the up back, and the fullback, Oscar Raby, able to fight for a little additional yardage, a 1st down to the 14.
I guess he's getting that ankle tackle to make sure they brought him down. That was Mark Manders on the tackle for Coon Rapids.
So now 1st and 10. From the 14 of the Cardinals. Pitch is going down to Bayou on the left side, waits for his blocking to set up, lowers his shoulders down inside the 10 and close to the 8.
Yeah, it's all about that. It's all about the play up front for St. Thomas. Looking to do a good job of just pushing the defensive front out of the way in order to pick up some positive yardage.
It's 5-yard gain, 2nd and 5 from the 9. Play action rolling out with time. Redding wants to do it himself, puts on a shake move down inside the five. It'll be first and goal from close to the two, it looks like.
Yeah, and he had Grady O'Neill in the back of the end zone open. I just don't know if he saw him or if he just felt that he was going to take it himself and see if he had the opportunity to run it in. But
he can put it right at the one. So a gain of eight, first and goal from the one. Redding on the quarterback sneak is into the end zone for the touchdown.
Well, the Cadets answer the Cardinals' score. Just good push up front. A little help from our friends as they manage to get in the end zone.
Nine plays to go 40 yards. It took 4 minutes and 11 seconds. And finished with the Baker Redding touchdown. The extra point is good for Seth Moore. And it is 30-8 in favor of St. Thomas.
Yeah, the Cardinals in a bit of a hole with this situation. And we've got this 5:11 remaining in the half.
Well, it's still time here for Coon Rapids. 5 minutes and 11 seconds remaining in the quarter, but they will have to kick it away to start the second half. They would love to get some points and not leave any time on the clock for St. Thomas, and have to hope that they can do a better job in the field position battle in half number two. But it all starts with the finish of the second quarter and trying to get back some more points, try and climb back into this one. Mark Rogalski will squib it again. This one taken from the 26-yard line. Finding some room out across the 40 to the 44 was Ryan Creamer, Max Walls.
You did what I did earlier.
I did.
Read from the wrong roster. It's our first football game of the year, so of course we're entitled to a couple mistakes. A game, a quarter.
A drive. Per play. So Coon Rapids' best fit starting field position of the game at their own 45-yard line. Tom with three receivers on his left, one to the right. He's got Gibley in the backfield with him. Throw is complete to the St. Thomas 49. Mustafa Munir on the catch.
Yeah, just a quick little throw to Munir. Just want to get some positive yardage. Would love to be able to come away with another score before this half is over for Coon Rapids.
First snap from the St. Thomas side of midfield for the Coon Rapids offense. Handoff goes to Gibley, and he's going to be met and driven back. He's going to lose a couple. We'll see where they mark him. It'll be third down.
Yeah, not much. I mean, look at the job. Look at the white jerseys just really doing a good job of beating their blockers at the point of attack, and really not much opportunity for Gibley on that one, met by Ricky McKinley. 5'11", 245 falling on top of you. There you see the numbers for Coon Rapids. 1 of 4 on third down.
Third and six from their own 49-yard line. Two receivers either side this time. Tom looks left, throws, passes tipped and incomplete. Intended for Jordan Doe. And Coon Rapids is going to be in a punting situation, and a flag coming in, pushing and shoving afterwards.
That's on Gavin Layton. He pushed the player to the ground right in front of the official, and they're going to catch you every time.
I didn't see it, but frustration foul?
I think so. It was unnecessary, obviously, but a little frustrating, I'm sure, on his behalf.
That means they're going to have to punt from ways further back. You know, that's 15 yards that are important when
Absolutely.
You're trying to climb back into a game.
Absolutely.
And it happened after the play, so it is fourth down.
Yeah, you saw it there. And Gavin is a very large human being, a very strong man. But he didn't need to do that. He's just bigger than everybody else.
Jordan Doe standing just inside his 20-yard line to punt.
Number four, Jordan Doe is in punt formation.
And a timeout for the Cardinals. 3:42 remaining first half. They trail 30-8. As it has been all St. Thomas Academy.
Oh, we know we talked about just on this drive how important it was for them to see if they maybe could get another score before half. Now it's just as important for the defense not to let another score in before the end of the half because there's still plenty of time left.
And St. Thomas with their full complement of timeouts as well. Yeah, quick takeaway or stop would be big. I mean, there would still be time, theoretically, if they can get the ball back to try and, again, get some more points to cut into this lead. But, you know, it starts with getting the stop.
Yeah, it does start with getting the stop, and that's the thing. And
the stop really has to start on special teams.
Right.
They can't continue to give this offense such excellent field position. They're only going to have Bickford back. They had Bickford and O'Neill back for all the previous punts, but just Bickford this time. Maybe out of that timeout, just want to make sure that they don't get caught on a fake. Good snap. Line drive, punt, bounces at the 40 and pretty much checks up. And Coon Rapids will down it at about the 38-yard line.
Well, not the kind of field position that they've been getting, but decent field position quite obviously for the Cadets' next drive. We have a flag on the play. I'm not sure what they had called, but we'll see here what our officials have to say, although I'm not sure we're hearing them.
On its back near the line of scrimmage.
They're calling it off.
No flag. So it will be first and 10 from the 37. The Cadets have only snapped the ball on their side of the field three times in this game. Not sure what their total play count is, but only three have been from their side of midfield.
Crazy.
So a total amount of snaps for the whole game on their side of midfield, four. This will be the first that has been inside of their 45 for either team. All game. Quick throw to the left, incomplete, too tall for Danny McFadden.
A bit of a dangerous throw by Redding. Just a quick throw to the outside, just three-step drop.
Redding out of the pistol this time with three receivers to his left. He's going to roll that way. Chase throws on the run, complete by McFadden as he shuffles out of bounds after a short gain. It'll be third down.
Let's take another look at that. I'm just not sure. Did he have control of it before he stepped out of bounds? I wasn't sure. It looked like he bobbled it at the second. But
stepped out of bounds for a short gain. Brings up third down.
Looks like he got it controlled.
He may have just gotten it in.
According to our official, he did, because yeah. He's a 2 yard gain. It's 3rd and 8. Out of Bayou is the lone setback. McFadden in the slot on the right. Pitch goes out of Bayou, trying to get around the corner, and does. He's going to have a big gain. And there's a flag in the backfield, and he slips another tackle. He's going all the way to the end zone. It's a 61-yard run for Love out of Bayou.
We'll
see what the flag is. Redding was down, so it may have been a late hit on Redding. But we'll see what happens with the flag. There's another flag further downfield at about the 12-yard line at Coon Rapids.
Head coach Dan O'Brien's getting an explanation from our official.
This
hit the back, somebody was saying.
The extra point team for Seth Moore is lining up, so the question is, how big a penalty is it, and will it be assessed on the kickoff? .306 on the clock. Just three plays to go 63 yards. In just 27 seconds. By the way, it's the official's first game of the season as well.
It is. There is definitely that. It's everybody's first game.
Legal use of hands was unsportsmanlike that way. Eagerly awaited the signal. After the play, illegal use of the hands, that is declined.
Unsportsmanlike.
Oh.
So block in the back is declined. Sportsmanlike conduct on St. Thomas Academy.
Okay, I thought they also indicated an unsportsmanlike against Coon Rapids, but here's another look at it out of Bayou again. Elusiveness, able to cut back against the grain, avoid the arm tackle of Max Walls, and take it 61 yards for the score. The extra point for Moore is up and good. It is 37-6.
Eight.
Don't short
him any
sorry,
points.
I apologize.
Yeah, just a beautiful run to him, and a nice job. A couple of missed tackles as well. And you know, you first game of the season, typically, especially when you haven't had any scrimmages, you know how much tackling they've done. I'm sure they've done some, but not a lot. And this is your first live action, and it's kind of get some opportunities to work on your tackling skills.
Not at all how the home team wanted to start their season. Down 37-8 with 3 minutes left in the first half. As big as it was when they got the ball with 5 minutes left for them to score and cut into the lead, even larger now.
Oh, there's no question about that. I mean, they're down down by this situation. And again, it's just they're just not getting going really on either side of the ball. They're not playing, I know, the way that they feel they're capable of. But give credit to St. Thomas Academy. They're running their offense very well, and their defense is playing tough.
Well, and the unsportsmanlike will give Coon Rapids maybe some better field position as they assess it on the kick. Jordan Doe returning, avoids some tackles and breaks free across midfield, and Moore tripped up as he gets to the 35, but this is going to come back.
Yeah.
A flag at the Coon Rapids 32.
Yeah, it's
and
a it's
and a player down for St. Thomas Academy.
Trias on the tackle, but that of course is against the Cardinals.
and just a great return. Best
to hold.
One of the most positive plays of the first half for Coon Rapids is coming back on a flag.
Yeah, I mean they've had a couple. We're gonna see. Well, they called it. I believe they called it a hold. I'm not sure where.
Oh, I think it was back over there.
Right where the fallen player was. Maybe.
And the flag.
Yeah, and the flag, correct.
But so instead of starting from the 35 of St. Thomas, they will start from their own 25.
That's a lot of field difference. Under 3 minutes remaining in the half. In a half that's been dominated.
Almost half the field, to be exact.
Dominated by St. Thomas Academy.
Handoff and a tackle for loss for the St. Thomas team defense.
And you got to love the push they're getting up front. I mean, you know, really.
Josh Dubois really had no chance. Nope. He was buried as soon as he had the ball.
Yep. Again, the Cardinals have some nice size up front. It's just that right now St. Thomas Academy is doing a better job of winning the battle at the point of attack.
Number 66, Oscar Burr.
Second and 12 from the 23. Out of the shotgun. Throw is complete. Nice job by Sonny Tausting with the pass. It was a little bit behind him. Going to be just shy of the first down.
Number 16, Griffin.
Again,
pass.
This is
complete.
You're right, just a bit behind him, but he did a nice job of bringing it in and making sure that he held on to it as he went to the ground.
Short.
Gain of 11 will set up third and one. David Gibley without his helmet on the sidelines. Pocket broke, but Tom able to rush for the first down out to the 40-yard line. 8-6.
Well, he saw the amount of real estate he had in front of him, and he didn't waste any time to make that decision. He knew that he was going to be able to run for the ball, or for the first down.
First and 10, Coon Rapids, from the 40-yard line.
Trips right for the Cardinals on first and 10 from the 40. Tom throwing left. Over the top. Wanted Darius Eulen down the left sideline, but it's incomplete.
I was visiting practice the other day before the soccer match that we did it. And Tom was throwing him downfield, and he was hitting his receivers. He likes to try and air it out.
Second and 10 from the 40. Pocket collapses again, tried to step up, but he's rolled up and sacked back at the 35-yard line, a loss of 5.
Yeah, not much he's going to do to get away from him in that situation. See, again, trying to step up into that pocket.
Second sack of the game for Oscar Berg.
Yeah, Oscar Berg's doing a nice job of just causing a lot of havoc.
Third and 14 from the 36. Rolling is Tom again, pressured, and again he is sacked. Dropped back at the 30. Finishing it off this time is Brendan Fitzgerald.
Yeah, and Berg was, if you see right there, Berg was right there initially, and he's the one that originally forced him to step up in the pocket. And then, as you talked about, Fitzgerald made sure he brought him to the ground.
So on 4th and 20 from the 30, Coon Rapids will roll the punting unit out. St. Thomas will take a timeout. Save what little remains in this first half, knowing they have a big lead already, and they will get the ball again to start the second half. But that lead can never be too big. The minute you think your lead is large enough, you may be in trouble.
You very well could be in that situation, but, you know, Coon Rapids offensively really has to get it going. You know, the long run by Gibley gave him the score, but they really haven't been outside of a nice run by Doe, which ended up coming back.
It was a kick return.
That's pretty much it. He ran
and
with the ball.
Well, and technically Gibley's was a reception.
Yeah.
But a bit of a concern to see Gibley not out for that offensive series and was standing on the sideline with his helmet off. Hope that he is okay.
Yeah, they can ill afford to lose him.
Jordan Doe will punt this one, standing at his own 15-yard line. Bickford and O'Neill are the deep back, standing at their own 37, 38-yard line. 48 seconds on the clock. Good punt for Doe. O'Neill will take it from his own 40. Bobbled it and had to go to a knee, so he's down right there.
So they'll start from their own 40 with just a shade over 40 seconds remaining in the half. We'll see if they, I mean, they did take a timeout, so we'll see what they want to do here.
Well, they've still got two more.
No, so I know.
I assume they'll come out and at least try and throw.
I would imagine.
One. I mean, certainly with how dangerous both out of Bayou and McFadden are, you run isn't a bad option for this team either.
It is very true.
Even from 60 yards out with little time. Out of the shotgun is Redding. Straight drop, looks left, now throws. Wants O'Neill, has him, but just out of his reach. He was behind the defender, but that pass just a little too far.
Yeah, Redding, I'm sure, would love to have that back because O'Neill did a really nice job of getting behind the defense. He had at least three steps. That play did not take a lot of time off the clock.
5 seconds. Single setback now is Adebayo on second and 10. Straight drop four, and they set up the screen to Adebayo. Avoids a couple of tackles, almost avoids a third, and finally caught up and dropped after a gain of six.
Yeah, time, they're going to let the time continue to run.
Down under 10 seconds remaining. Redding throwing long on the right side, has a man. It is complete. Tied up and dropped down at the 1 yard line as time expires. He got TJ Adams, but Adams is tied up and tackled short of the goal line, and that's how the half will end. Tabla, a touchdown saving tackle, but still a 37-8 lead for St. Thomas Academy as we go to the half. You're watching CTN's live coverage of Prep football.
I'm not sure. I think it's over. Yeah, I don't know why they were even lining up. This clock was definitely out.
It's definitely zeros before the ball was dead.
Yep.
So that is how it will end. A pass of 53 yards down to the 2 yard line. But that will take us to the half. It's 37 for St. Thomas Academy, 8-4 Coon Rapids. You're watching CTN's live coverage of the 2020 Prep Football Opener. This is my kingdom
come. This is my kingdom come. Hi, I'm Ryan Nagasu, 2010 Olympian and bronze medal winner of the 2014 U.S. Championships. I knew I loved skating at the age of 5, and now it's become my life passion. Find your skating passion at the Coon Rapids Ice Center. Classes are available all year round. It could be the place where your skating dreams come true. See you on ice.
Back at the Cardinal Stadium, it's been the Cadets' night on opening night as they have trounced the home team thus far. They've had great field position, and they've taken advantage every time they've touched the ball. Started with a little swing pass to Danny McFadden from 14 yards out. That made it 7-0. Then it was a McFadden 7-yard touchdown run that made it 14-0. Coon Rapids went backwards their first three possessions. This one, a bad snap that went into the end zone, resulted in a safety, made it 16-0. And just three plays later, it was Danny McFadden trotting into the end zone for his third score of the game. Coon Rapids was able to answer that one relatively quickly. A huge play, great job adjusting by David Giebley. A little screen pass turns it into a 70-yard sprint to the far pylon that put Coon Rapids on the board. They were able to get the two-point conversion on a little swing pass to Jordan Doe, but quarterback sneak for Baker Redding made it 30-8. And then another long run. This one, a 61-yard scamper for Love Adebayo. That made it 37-8. And then they nearly added another score in the final game of, or final play of the first half. Long pass to the right to find TJ Adams. He's taken down inside the 5-yard line as time expires. But yeah, St. Thomas has been dominant.
Well, look at the, I mean, look at this. Look at that. 285 yards of total offense.
And look then, at this. And me first. Yeah. Look at that. Yeah. 58 yards.
And look at that.
It was a 70-yard touchdown. So outside of that one play, the Coon Rapids offense has gone backwards.
Here's the positive. No turnovers. Only two first downs, which, you know, you can tell we're getting used out of this today. But they've got their work cut out for them. They're going to have to make some adjustments here at the break.
And the Cadets will start with the ball as we get the second half underway. Kickoff coming up next on CTN.
Showing in the 100 butterfly, she can't quite catch the leader.
And it's hard to throw you for a loop.
So. No, not when it comes to swimming. So.
Second half ready to get underway. Ali Abdelrahim to boot it away for the Cardinals. High kick will be taken and bounces away at the 28 from Bickford. He's able to get back on top of it, and the Cadets will start near their own 25-yard line.
Yeah, he was fortunate. That would have been a break that the Cardinals certainly could have used if they were able to jump on that loose football.
25. Furthest that they have been in their own end.
Well, Joe, I'd say this is a big first drive for the defense of the second half. And again, you know, the Cadets have been scoring at will for the most part.
Redding in trouble, running and throws it away.
Smartly.
In the vicinity of his tight end, Simon Kotok. Well, incomplete.
He was being tracked down by David Giebley. And we have a Cardinal down. Is that Giebley? You can't see who that is. I think it's Giebley.
I think it is.
Yeah. That's not good. He's still on the field. He can't.
Well, and again, he was not on the field for the Cardinals' last offensive possession of the first half. Hope it is nothing more than a cramp. It is unseasonably warm
it
and
is
humid.
For this time of year, correct.
And, of course, you know, you talked about it. You know, get practice is one thing, but a lot of things change when you're in actual competition, including how much hydration your body needs. And let's hope it is nothing worse than that.
I think that's what it is. Yeah, I really think it's a cramp.
Well, he is up and he is walking on his own power, but definitely gingerly. And we will have to wait and watch for his return.
Yeah, he is walking gingerly on it, but it doesn't look like an injury where he can't put weight on it, but I think it definitely is a cramp because as he's walking, he looks like he's walking with a little more authority as he continues across the field. And we certainly hope that young man is okay.
And as we talked about in the first half, a big part of the Cardinals' offense and defense.
Yep.
And now it'll be second and 10 for St. Thomas Academy from their own 25-yard line. I formation in the backfield. Now sprints McFadden out to the right. Little swing pass his way is incomplete up over his head. And fortunate that that was at least parallel to the line of scrimmage. It looked like it might be a fumble. It still would have gone out of bounds.
Correct.
They do not lose any yardage, third and 10.
And this is a situation with the defense to bring it and get a stop.
One of the few times that St. Thomas has had a third down where it is not four down territory. McFadden in the backfield to the left of Baker Redding. Redding will roll to his right, looking downfield, now throwing, wants Pasiga. Has him down the sideline, broken up in the last minute. Pasiga made a great effort to come back to the ball, but it does fall incomplete, and St. Thomas Academy will be punting for the first time tonight.
Yeah, it's something we're not used to seeing here in this game from the cadets is a punt, and you can see Pasiga just trying to stay with that football, two defenders on him.
Well, and it was just a great play by the safety, Manders, to come over and get support. Tableau was with him. He was in a good position, but Manders came over and got a hand on it, made sure it wasn't getting through. So Redding will be the punter. Takes down a high snap at his own 10, nearly blocked, but got it away. It will bounce and roll in the cadets' favor, but Coon Rapids will start from their own 40-yard line.
Yeah, decent field position for the Cardinals here. They forced the cadets to go three and out, which is something they haven't done all game. That's the way they wanted to start this half here.
And they will take over with some of their best starting field position. And one drive start at the 10. A couple others at the 20. Did have one that started at their own 45, but so far, a good start to this second half, and they need it on first down. Throwing is Tom. The pass is complete. Doe had to come back to the ball, so only a short gain. They might give him three.
Yeah, it looks like it. Just that quick throw and good defense there. They're all over Jordan Doe. That was Jack Schwab on the tackle for St. Thomas Academy.
Tom with three receivers to his right. He'll roll that way. Looking, now throws. Pass is complete. Incomplete. Sonny Tao tried to get the feet down, but ruled out of bounds. Incomplete.
Oh, nice job. Nice job bringing it in.
Well, and Sonny still thinks he made the catch.
He does. Well, he's still pleading his case.
I thought he got his feet down. All you need is one.
Yep.
Hard to tell from that angle,
he's out of bounds.
Clearly our official had a better look at it.
Correct.
Coon Rapids trying to avoid going three and out to start the second half here. Third and 7 from their own 43. Three wide to the right, one wide to the left. Tom throws incomplete over the head of Sonny Tao, and Coon Rapids will be punting.
And not what they wanted after a pretty good field position just to go the three and out. Tom is saying, my bad. That was my bad throw. Are they going for it?
Coon Rapids leaving the offense on the field on fourth and seven. And you're down 37-8.
Why not, right? But you give them good field position if you don't convert.
No worse than what they've had or
well,
had
I don't
so
disagree
far.
With you. I don't disagree with you.
Definitely a gamble, though. For an offense, I think, that only has two plays that have gone more than 7 yards. On fourth and seven, Tom chased, throws right, incomplete, looking for Jordan Doe. And it's a quick turnover on downs for the Cardinals.
And again, it keeps it puts the Cadets into Cardinal territory to start this drive. And Tom trying to step up in the pocket and then releasing it, but good coverage on the play by the Cadets. This one has been all St. Thomas.
Coon Rapids being aggressive, I don't mind that call.
Nope.
But
well, you need a spark.
Now you need your defense. You put more pressure back on that defense. It spent a lot of time on the field in the first half.
You really do. And
O'Neill is going to take over under center for St. Thomas Academy. Handoff goes to the up back, Robbie. Robbie, short gain.
See, and this is a situation as this game continues, for St. Thomas, you can get some players in, some action that may not necessarily see it in a tight contest.
Grady O'Neill's been out as a receiver for most of the game. He's returned kicks and punts and now taking over at the quarterback position out of the pistol on second and nine. They run the option. He'll pitch to Adebayo. Adebayo trying to get around the corner.
Pretty close.
He'll be right near the first down marker.
I think he might have it. Depending on where they spot it, but I think he might have it. Again, and just a nice job, quick pitch.
He is going to have the first down.
He's using that speed to gain the edge.
And now O'Neill will go up under center with the I formation behind him. Fakes the give, rolls left, he spins away, in trouble, coughed up the football. Looks like the St. Thomas Academy Cadets able to get it back.
Great opportunity for the Cardinals defense to fall on that loose football. You see it here. It's just carrying that ball out there like a loaf of bread, and that's something he's got to learn to be able to tuck that ball away, unfortunately. The Cadets able to fall on it.
Loss of two makes it second and 12.
That's for Robbie on the recovery for the Cadets.
Tight end on the right side, I formation behind O'Neill on second and long. Handoff goes out of Bayo. Gets out of a tackle and keeps his feet moving. And he's going to be close to another first down.
I mean, you touched it, the key, Joe, keeping your feet moving, and that's exactly what he did. I mean, you're going to see it coming up here is that he's just pulling out of a tackle by continuing to run through it. Nice set. Nice
needed 12, got 12. Another first down. Ball at the Coon Rapids 23-yard line. Handoff goes to Robbie. He's got a hole on the left side. He's not going to move out of your way, but he is going to try and run you over. He's down to the 16-yard line, a gain of 7.
Yeah, he's definitely a north-south runner as he applies pressure at the end of that run.
Handoff goes to McFadden. He's got a nice hole on the left side and another nice gain down to the 5-yard line, first and goal.
Yeah, again, continuing to do what they want to do against this defense of Coon Rapids. A missed tackle there. And I mean, he's so quick through the middle that you got to get a good piece of him. Otherwise, he's just going to run past you.
Ball spotted at the 6, where it will be first and goal. Adebayo is the deep back behind Robbie. He'll get the carry, looking for room, left side. Follows his block, pushed wide, and he'll have no gain. Second down.
Hunter Allen on the tackle, doing a nice job of just making sure he stayed with him wide. And then brought him to the ground, didn't let him get out of his grasp.
A lot of black jerseys chasing him down that line of scrimmage and forcing him eventually backwards, but ball spotted at the 6, no gain, second and goal. Out of the pistol this time is O'Neal as Adebayo back there with him. They run the option to the right. He will keep it himself, turn upfield and into the end zone. Touchdown, St. Thomas Academy.
Again, just a nice drive, and they're able to convert again. And you can see why they're such a good team year after year. They reload. They've got some very quality athletes in that program. And even though they lost 17 starters from a year ago, they are showing no signs of slowing down in terms of being a quality ball club.
Moore's kick is up and good. It is 44-8, St. Thomas Academy.
Yeah, you know, Coon Rapids is going to scratch their heads a little bit about what they can do here forward, but, you know, they're not going to play a team the quality of St. Thomas Academy each and every week. So, you know, they're going to just have to.
Doubtful they'll see another team this good.
No, not this good. Not this good. Not this good. They'll see some good teams, but not like this.
Plenty to celebrate on this night for the Cadets. 6 trips to the end zone. And outside of one big play, their defense has been rock solid.
Yeah, they really have. And that one big play to a quality athlete.
Jordan Doe awaits. Kick from Rovalski is another short one, scooped up, but on a knee when he scooped it up with Sonny Tao, so ball is immediately dead. I take that back. That was Ryan Creamer who scooped it up. Max Walls.
Again, yeah, you looked at the wrong roster.
I knew that. I was just testing you, really.
And I passed because I pointed that.
Good job. Good job. Way to pay attention, Shapiro.
Thanks. I do it every third play.
Tom out of the shotgun on first and 10 from his own 30-yard line. The handoff goes to Dubois, and he is dropped for a loss.
Yeah, he's smothered there. And again, it's all about winning that battle up front. All about it. It's all the way on the tackle. He's been active for the Cadets.
Loss of 5. Second and 15. Tom drops, rolls, throws, passes complete to Jordan Noah. First down out across the 40-yard line.
The ball came out, but he was definitely on the ground before that happened. But that was a very nice throw from Tom. I mean, he put it right where Doe could run through it.
They saw that he was down before the ball came out. And small victories. See, celebrate every first down at this point.
Yeah, that's against the Cardinals.
Gonna back it up. No, it wasn't.
Oh, it was defense.
See how you are? Jumping to conclusions? They were
just
jumping.
Like they did. Just like they did. They jumped in neutral zone.
They did. So it'll be first and 5.
I'm glad I was wrong.
Well, and pretty clean game on both sides. You know, a couple of frustration penalties on both sides.
Yep.
And a big hit. Ball came out. Coon Rapids able to get back on top of it. But Griffin Tom took a big, big hit.
Yeah, that was Garrison Soliday again. We've mentioned his name several times tonight for the Cadets on the defensive side of the ball. And again, he just put him down to the turf, and Tom could not hold on to the football. Unfortunately for Coon Rapids, Dubois was there to fall on it. Well, they lost.
Loss of 7 yards.
7, yep.
6 yards. Second and 11. Receiver screen to Jordan Doe, left side, trying to find some room after the catch out to about the 48 where he's pushed out. It'll be third and short.
Again, Doe's one of those athletes as well. He's got that, has good acceleration. Is Jeebly on the sideline running, trying to see if he can get back into this game.
Third and 3 from their own 47. They send 3 receivers to the right. Tom looking left, sets up the screen, complete to Dubois. He's got the first down into St. Thomas Academy territory.
And that's what Coon Rapids wants here, they certainly need, is a sustained drive if they can have it. And they're just a good job. Tom doing a good job of waiting for the pressure to clear and dumps it off to Dubois.
Tom waiting. Pass is complete, but this one's coming back. Yeah. There's a hole in the backfield.
Yeah. Again, another nice quick release by Tom, but it's unfortunately, as you mentioned, it's going to be a hold against Coon Rapids.
Well, and I don't think that Dubois has to make that
to the
hold.
Ground. Nope.
Oh, is it the?
No,
oh, yeah,
it was right
it was
here.
That one. Take your pick. Either one was a hold. I'm not sure either was necessary.
No.
Because he did, as you mentioned, got the ball out quickly. So instead of a solid gain, it's going to march the Cardinals back. And because it happened in the backfield, it's going to march them back a long way. They're back to their own 34-yard line. essentially a 16-yard loss from the previous line of scrimmage. So it'll be first and 26. 27, they say, on the board. Handoff goes to DuBois. He's met almost immediately and stopped at about the 34-yard line. Jordan Doe, the man in motion on second and long. They hand off to DuBois again, and he is going to get two. It'll be third and long.
Yeah, defense does such a nice job of collapsing quickly, and that no running room for him, for DuBois. And you see those white jerseys just to collapse around the ball carrier and bring him down with the short gate.
Third and 25 for the Cardinals.
You see the numbers, 3 of 9 on third down for Coon Rapids so far through this contest.
Passing left and miscommunication, nobody in the area. And I assume the Coon Rapids would put the punt team out, but it doesn't look that way. They figure already down by.
No, they're punting the ball.
Okay.
On fourth and 25, in this part of the field, you need to punt the ball.
I
would think.
Typically, but you know, I wouldn't second guess. You know.
Yeah.
If you're, you know, feel you're already out of the ball game, you're just gonna. Go desperation mode.
Yeah, what it would be.
But yeah, you don't have a lot in the playbook for fourth and 25, other than the punt. Doe a short end over end punt coming to the near side. Going to take a Coon Rapids bounce. And it'll be down just inside the 40-yard line by Max Walsh.
We do have a flag on the play. Not sure what they called.
Two flags on the field.
Right in the same area.
Replay fourth down.
Yeah, you saw a hold on the Cadets and a personal foul on the Cardinals and offset. But good field position for St. Thomas to start their next drive.
Maybe, maybe not. Maybe they bobble this and give it back to Coon Rapids.
Maybe. We'll see.
It would have been at the 30. They would have had it at their own 39-yard line. See if the re-kick...
I hope you're correct, Yend.
Just saying. Will their fates improve by doing it over? We shall see. Jordan Dole punting from about his own 20-yard line. He's had a busy night booting the ball. Low snap, gets it on a hop. Gets away a decent kick. It is bobbled by Bickford, but he's able to scoop it back up. And he's able to fight his way out as far as the 43, maybe the 44-yard line. So
a little bit better.
They did get about 5 yards better. Well, they put him all the way out to 45. Had a Coon Rapids ball on the field. Got to get a St. Thomas Academy ball on the field. COVID. Welcome to 2020 rules. It matters which way, which side the football comes from. Under center is O'Neill. He hands off to Adebayo. Bayou spins away from a tackle. Finds a little bit of space. Picks up speed. Cuts back. Has another big gain down inside the 40 to the 36-yard line.
Again, you know, he talked about, you know, field vision and of Gibley. He also has pretty good field vision as he's able to see a bit of a hole, cut back inside and pick up some additional yardage.
On
eight carries in a touchdown.
Well, that one for 19.
So good to have Harley in here with us. Harley Schultz, the best stat guy in the business.
The stats guru.
The guru.
That makes us
the
real.
Wizard.
O'Neill, straight drop, looks left, or looks right, throws, pass is complete. Billy Kozlak on the reception.
Just gets out of bounds with 1.5 seconds remaining in the third quarter.
Second and really less than a yard. Handoff goes up the middle to Robbie. He'll have a first down as the buzzer sounds and ends the third quarter. We go to the fourth. St. Thomas 44, Coon Rapids 8. You're watching the 2020 season opener live on CTN.
Rapids Recycling Center can help you recycle all of your old appliances and electronics. From your old refrigerator to washers and dryers, we can help you recycle your appliances and keep them out of the waste stream, which is required by state law. When it comes to electronics, some fees may apply. Check our website for more details. The Coon Rapids Recycling Center, helping you recycle even more.
At Cardinal Stadium, St. Thomas Academy picks up another first down, and they are coasting a 44-8 lead as we get ready to start the fourth quarter. They will have it first and 10 from the Coon Rapids 25.
Yeah, the Cards will just have to put this game behind them and just move forward and learn from mistakes they made.
Well, it was something they were able to do last year, clearly.
Exactly.
They lost to the... They were in that game. They were down 12-0 at the half.
Yep, and then they turned the ball over at the goal line, didn't they?
Well, they didn't turn it over, but
they
got stopped.
On down.
No, they got stopped, and time expired.
Oh, that's right.
They had three straight chances on first and second and third and goal from the one. Three chances at the end of the first half. and they got held at the goal line. And that, I mean, if they get in and it's 12-7, it's completely different. But St. Thomas did go on to win that game 34-0. And Coon Rapids went on to have their best season since 1983.
There's a flag on the play.
Those have come with the increasing regularity. Joe Kohler on the carry.
Joe Kohler for the Cadets. Left out of the play. But it's 10. Chip Kiffmeyer for the Cardinals.
And with the 36-point lead, it will be running time in the fourth quarter. So false start backs him up. First and 15 from the 30. O'Neill pitches it to the right. Ball came out. Was Kohler able to get it back?
Yeah.
Yes, he was.
Yeah, he was
just took
to
his eyes off it at the last second. It looked like a pretty good pitch.
Yeah.
Oh, it was,
that was
a little
behind
bit
him.
Behind him.
Yeah.
Number 48, Joe Kohler, for the Cadets.
So three times St. Thomas has put it on the turf, but all three they've been able to get back on top of. It's a loss of 8, though, so all of a sudden it's 2nd and 23.
Second.
Rolling out O'Neill. Here come a lot of black jerseys in trouble, able to throw it away toward the feet of Eli Rome and at least avoid losing any more yards.
Number 7. Good time there by the Cardinal defense to bring the pressure.
Pass was incomplete. Pressure on the play by number.
Several there. Cardinals in pursuit. Kendrick Dowdle was the one that nearly got a paw on him. 3rd and 23 now from the 38. Not a lot in your playbook for
no.
that.
No. Kind of like 4th and 25 in the Cardinal playbook.
You have the punt in the playbook for that.
Well, that you do. But we talked. Well, if they had gone for it, they just didn't have anything, so they felt the better punt.
That's probably wise.
There's a flag.
The receiver on the far side, Danny Eldridge, was about 3 yards upfield.
I know.
Whoops, forgot to look for my mark. So let's back him up 5 more yards. He just got a little bit, you know, excited. He gets in late in the game, lined up on the wrong official. You can't line up with the back judge. Oh, unless they were able to call a timeout before. I mean, I saw a flag fly.
Yeah.
I haven't seen him. Oh, they did back it up.
Yeah.
Okay. And the timeout.
No timeout. So the clock will continue
to
run.
False start. Yeah. 3rd and 28.
That's even less.
Back to the 43. I've got one play in my playbook for the 3rd and 28.
What is it?
Punt.
On 3rd?
Sure. Catches him off guard.
Apparently it would.
I would think you'd throw the ball. I would assume.
I would assume you would.
I mean, especially with running time now, it doesn't matter in that effort. High snap brought down by O'Neill. O'Neill just wants to run and try and get away from black jerseys, and he does with positive effects. He makes his way back down close to the 35-yard line of gain of about 8. It'll still be 4th and 20 and still in, you know, 4 down territory.
Well, and he did a nice job of bringing that that high snap in as well, and then making some nice positive play as the result.
So they put it at the 36, call it 4th and 21.
For the Cadets, brought down to the play, a bit of 10, Jacob Kiffmeyer for the Cardinals. Fourth and 20 for the Cadets. Here you go, Carter fans. Help up that team. Make some noise.
Out of the shotgun is O'Neal on fourth and very long. Another high snap, able to bring it down. The pass is complete, and they are going to get the first down to the 10-yard line. Jax Zubner able to find a seam, and O'Neal able to put the ball on him.
And he, you know, and he was pressured too, and they did a nice job of releasing it.
First and 10 for the Cadets.
At the 11, a gain of 25. They needed 21, they got 25, first and 10 from the 11. Handoff again goes to Kohler. Trying to fight his way through the middle, gets down to about the 7-yard line, gain of 4.
Yeah, again, they're just being methodical. After that nice pass by O'Neal to gain that long first down, and they're just being methodical with this drive. Looking to add an additional score.
It'll be second and 5 from the 6.
Now we have a new quarterback in there is Noah Erickson.
Hands off to Kohler. Kohler follows his blockers, leans forward. He's going to be stopped just short of the goal line, but I believe it'll be a fresh set of downs from the 1.
It will be. And Erickson comes in and the handoff to Kohler. Yeah, right at the right at the doorstep.
Erickson under center on, he dropped it. Able to get back on top of it again. St. Thomas Academy putting it on the turf, but able to get back.
Yeah, and that's just I think the snap was okay. I just don't think he handled it clearly or cleanly.
You get nervous, your palms get sweaty. You should know all about that.
Believe me, every day that's my life.
Now it looks like they leave it at the 1-yard line where it'll be second and goal. Erickson hands off to Kohler, left side, touchdown St. Thomas Academy.
Yeah, again, they convert, continue to grow this lead. Really on that long third down pass conversion, able to keep that drive going and able to hit pay dirt again. Kohler pushes it through.
Moore's kick is up. It is good. It is 51-8.
We'll see another view of that. Oh, that's the one they put the ball on the turf. And then here's the touchdown by Kohler. He's able to get over the stripe, standing up.
So less than 4 minutes remaining in the contest. Clock does stop for the score. So if you call a timeout when it's running time. Does the clock stop?
I think it does. I think so.
Rogalski to kick it away again. Another squibber that rolls up the middle, taken at the 20-yard line. Walls with speed down the left side across the 45, chased out of bounds before midfield, but good return and solid field position.
Cardinals would like to see what they can do here and maybe put some points on the board before the end of this game. Just finish this game with something positive.
Jordan Doe starts in the backfield, swings out to the left. They wanted to get him down that sideline, and it's a dangerous pass. Tommy
really
threw
dangerous.
That into three white jerseys and a receiver that wasn't looking for it.
Yeah.
Tom with three receivers on the right side this time. A little play action. A little receiver screen is complete on the right side to Nathan Cavanaugh, and he had a great run after the catch down to the 36-yard line for a first down.
Yeah, the quick throw to the outside, and Cavanaugh, as you mentioned, did a good job of seeing where his blockers were, and then broke away from a tackle, did a nice stutter step into the inside, able to pick up some additional yards.
First and 10 from the 36. Quickly to the Cavanaugh on the left side on a receiver screen. Tries to find a similar hole. Not much as much there. He's going to pick up about 8.
Cavanaugh listed at 5'5 and 125.
That's a big kid.
He took a nice hit at the end, bounced right back up.
Quick pass, complete right side this time. That Sonny Tau twisted down at the 25. No, it's Mustafa Munir.
Yep. Oh, and he's hobbling a little bit. He's going to head to the sideline.
We'll get the Cardinals a first down to the 25. Hand off to Dubois. And he's going to gain a couple off the right side.
Down the last 45 seconds.
Second down.
Looking right, pass incomplete. Intended for, is that Robbie down the right sideline? So George Steveken.
I didn't see the number.
Either way, incomplete, third and 8. Chase from the pocket is Tom. He'll throw on the run, took a hard hit as he let it go. It's incomplete, and the game is over.
Yeah, tough opening loss for Coon Rapids. Is, you know, they had such a fine season last year, and they did lose so many players, and now an opportunity to kind of rebuild a little bit. And this isn't the way they wanted their season to start out.
No, but it is a season, and that was in doubt until just a few weeks ago. The Cardinals knew that it would be a great challenge, a great test to start out against this very quality St. Thomas Academy team. And now they know that, you know, they've put themselves out there against the best. They hope they can learn some lessons and get something, a few more things to go their way next week when they travel to Forest Lake. Howie, we will be there. We'll have girls volleyball on Monday from Rogers. Soccer playoffs hopefully on Tuesday or Wednesday, depending on when they're playing. And then we will have coverage of that football game for you here. But that is going to do it for this edition of CTN Sports. Again, the final score from the complex, it's St. Thomas Academy 51, Coon Rapids 8. I want to thank everybody out there for joining us and continuing to support everything we do here at CTN. For the entire crew, including Howie Shapiro, I'm Joe Young. Saying-